Good morning, class 12 students of Bio Group. As you know, we are now on the 13th part, doing 13th video, and we are continuing with Chapter 8, Evidences and Theories of Biological Evolution. Now, last time, if you remember, we looked at the causes of variations and the sources of variations. Out of the six sources of variation, mutations, we did last time. Now we'll be doing recombinations, migration, genetic drift, genetic flow, and selection. We looked at the first one last time, and we looked at the effects of mutation. Today we will look from the second one onwards. And here we look at recombinations. What is recombination? A gene mixing that causes during sexual reproduction is known as genetic recombination. If you have a look at this diagram here, you will see that in meiosis, it is showing that there is a genetic recombination taking place between the homologous chromosomes. We see the inner chromatids and the chiasma being formed, and a crossing over takes place here. So we see that this is unique feature of recombination, that each individual entering a population by sexual reproduction carries a unique combination of genes, of which half is donated by the mother. So we saw this, half is donated by the mother and half is donated by the father. So we see in this, half is donated by the father. During meiosis, variety in is generated in the gametes through crossing over between homologous chromosomes. Let us see the crossing over here of homologous chromosomes. And independent assortment of non-homologous chromosomes. This makes possible millions of combinations. Now, because of this, we see due to crossing over and at the point of chiasma, we get the recombinant chromosomes. Do you see here? The recombinant chromosomes. And these two on either side are the non-recombinant chromosomes. So we'll be talking about this. Let us go on again. During meiosis, variety is generated in the gametes through crossing over between homologous chromosomes. So we see crossing over is taking place between homologous chromosomes. And independent assortment of non-homologous chromosomes. This makes possible millions of combinations of genes in the gametes of an individual. When fertilization occurs, one of the millions of sperms unites with one of the millions of eggs, resulting in a genetically unique individual. So, recombination brings lot of variation. The recombination doesn't directly change the frequency of alleles within the gene pool. Now, what is gene pool? Gene pool refers to the total number of genes of every individual in a population. What does gene pool represent? Gene pool, children, refers to the total number of genes of every individual in a population. So, the recombination doesn't generally change the frequency of alleles within the gene pool, but the new member may have a unique combination of characteristics so superior to those of other members of the population. The new member would be much more successful in producing offsprings. Now, what is gene conversion? Let us look at the definition of gene conversion. It is a type of recombination that is the product of DNA repair. What is gene conversion? It is a type of recombination that is the product of DNA repair, where nucleotide damage is corrected using orthologous genomic region. What is orthologous? Orthologous means homologous genes. So, gene conversion is a type of recombination that is the product of DNA repair, where nucleotide damage is corrected. Let me show you the diagram. Let me show you the diagram quickly of gene conversion. Here we see that it is a type of recombination that is product of DNA repair, where nucleotide damage is corrected using orthologous genomic region or the homologous gene region as a template. So this is used as a template. The homologous gene region is used as a template so as to repair the DNA where the nucleotide is damaged. Gene conversion is often responsible for homogenizing sequence of a duplicate genes over long time periods, reducing nucleotide divergence. So gene conversion is often responsible for homogenizing sequence of duplicate genes over long time periods, reducing nucleotide divergence. Now let us look at the third aspect of the variation. We see migration. The migration is a movement. It can be of birds, it can be of animals, to find better pastures, to find better places of breeding or feeding. The animals and the birds, they migrate to different places. The migration of individuals from one gene to another is also an important way for alleles to be added to or subtracted from a local population. Now, what is a gene? Gene is a subdivision of a population consisting of closely related organisms. What is a deem, children? D-E-M-E, deem. Deem is a subdivision of a population consisting of closely related organisms. Is it clear? So, the migration of individuals from one deem to another is also an important way for alleles to be added or subtracted from a local population. When an organism leaves one population and enters another, it subtracts its genetic information from the population it left and adds it to the population it joins. When an organism leaves its bunch, its population, and it goes into another population, what it does, the organism leaves its genetic information into the new population that it joins. Second aspect of migration is if organism contains rare alleles or the contrasting characteristics, it may significantly affect the allele frequency of both populations. If organism contains rare alleles or the rare gene characteristics, it may significantly affect the allele frequency of both populations. What is the third effect of migration? The extent of migration need not be great as long as alleles are entering or leaving a population. The gene pool will change. Example, in zoos, we see children, too much interbreeding takes place in zoos, and so the genetic variety is reduced. Whereas in open forest, we see in open forest areas, a lot of recombinations take place when the animals migrate into vast areas of the forest. Then they mate together, and the male and female mating produces variations and recombinations, and this is increased and makes stronger genetic framework for the oncoming generations or the offspring. Then the fourth aspect of variations we see is genetic drift, and this describes changes in gene frequency that cannot be ascribed to selective pressures. Now, how do we define genetic drift? We can define it. It refers to the fact that variation in gene frequencies within population can occur by chance. It is an important mechanism in evolutionary change in small or isolated populations. What is the meaning of gene frequencies, the word that we used here? Gene frequencies actually are proportions or of different alleles of a gene in a population. What is gene frequency? Gene frequencies are proportions of different alleles of a gene in a population. Different allele means an allele can be of fairness and darkness, and allele can be of tallness and dwarfness. So we see that what does genetic drift means? It refers to the fact that variation in gene frequencies within population can occur by chance. It is an important mechanism in evolutionary change in small or isolated populations. Now, let us look at one of the aspects of gene drift. In a small population, not all the alleles that are representative of that species can be present. Example, let us understand this with an example. When premature accidental death takes place prior to mating of organisms, suppose there is an organism and that organism, he dies prematurely before he mates, which was sole possessor of a particular allele. Now, there was an allele which was a good strong characteristic of that organism, but as a result of his death, it results in elimination of that allele from that population. In a population of 1 lakh, an allele has a frequency of 1%, meaning 10,000 individuals would have that allele. Let us see this example again. In a population of 1 lakh, an allele has a frequency of 1%, meaning at least 10,000 individuals would have that allele. While in a smaller population of 100, only one individual would possess that allele. So, it is possible for an allele to disappear from a population or to drift to higher frequency simply by chance. In due course, it may lead to the origin of new species by natural selection. It is possible for an allele to disappear from a population or to drift to higher frequency simply by chance. In due course, it may lead to the origin of new species by natural selection. Then, in genetic drift, what happens? While genetic drift may lead to a reduction in variation within a population, it can also increase variation within the species as a whole. Now, let us look at the fifth aspect of variation, gene flow. What is gene flow? It is the movement of allele within a population. But strictly speaking, gene flow refers to the movement of alleles from one population to another as a result of interbreeding between the members of the two populations. Let us see the effect of gene flow one by one. The random introduction of new alleles into the recipient population and their removal from the donor population affects the allele frequencies of both populations and leads to increased genetic variation. So what happens? Random introduction of new alleles into a population makes that population a recipient population, and the individual has come from another population. So that population which donates that allele through that organism is known as the donor population. This affects the allele frequencies of both populations and leads to increased genetic variation. Then we see the second aspect of gene flow. The frequencies of gene flow between populations depends upon their geographical proximity and ease with which gametes can pass between two populations. So sometimes there is a barrier, there can be a barrier of a huge mountain in between, so the populations are on either side of that mountain, so it is not easy for the gametes to be transferred between the populations. But on the other hand, if they are in near proximity of each other, the two populations, then it is easier for the gametes to be transferred or to be passed between the two populations. Then we come to the sixth aspect of variation, which is known as selection. What is selection? It is a process by which new species are born. Those organisms which appear physically, physiologically, and behaviorally better adapted to the environment survive and reproduce. These organisms not so well adapted either fail to reproduce or they die. But we see another set of organisms, the better adapted organisms, the less adapted or the poor adapted organisms, they died. And so they could not survive in a certain environment. But the better adapted organisms, they pass on their successful characteristics to the next generation. Whereas the not so well adapted ones are not able to do it. We see there are three types of selection processes occurring in natural and artificial populations. And they are called, three of them are given here: stabilizing selection, directional selection, and disruptive selection. Now we will study in detail about this in the next lecture and the next video. So children, wish you all the best and have a good day. Thank you.